Hello, I'm Angry Terrapin, and on today's episode, we're going to do some fishing. 20 straight minutes of fishing. I thought this would make a really fun episode. Oh, we got one. Only joking. No, today I have a couple of projects in mind actually, but the first one on my list is the storage room. Which is getting desperately needed now. Been very, very busy between episodes though. First of all, just clear that out. First thing I did is fix the iron farm, finally. There's now 10 or maybe 12 villagers in here, all trapped in one by one squares. And this thing is churning out the iron now. I timed it over an hour. The first hour that it was working actually made 47 iron. I've not been on much since then. But yeah, up to 2 stacks already. What else have I been doing? Go down to the base. I've cleared out some space through the back here. Haven't quite decided what I was doing yet, I just got busy with the pickaxe and off I went. Through here though is where I'm going to be working today. This is going to be my manual storage room. This isn't going to have any kind of automatic sorting in it. There'll be chests here, maybe 2 high. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. There'll be 16 chests, 16 double chests in there. And because it's me, I'm going to make it a little bit fancy as well. I've got an idea in mind for that. Decoration-wise, I haven't quite decided yet, though. I imagine there's going to be some pillars here. Perhaps get rid of these walls as well, or maybe pull it one forward. I'm not sure. Yeah, we'll get to that in a bit anyway. But I need loads of supplies to get together for this still. Got pretty much nothing. And a pair of boots. So I'll go and fetch those and catch you again shortly. My plan is to have some pressure plates here. And they're going to be linked to dispensers that sit above the chests. So that when you walk in, the dispensers will have water already running out of them. But when you walk in, the water will be sucked up by the dispensers and the chests will all be sat probably one block lower, I think, actually. So we'll have the chests like this. And then this floor will go down by another block. Maybe half slabbed. Not too sure yet. But yes, the idea is that when you walk in, you'll trigger the pressure plates, which I'll put in now. And that will take the water away, the chests will be exposed. I think they'll still be accessible through the water, but yeah, it'll just look fun. And then these pillars as well, I thought I'd give it a nice big ceiling. Something with an arch, maybe, that extends all the way up there. But let's see if we can do some of this on camera. The first thing I want to do is get rid of this grass. And replace that with some logs. And then the pressure plates will sit in the middle. Which means I need to dig down under these another one. Redstone on all of those. And then lead this way. Yep. I've only got enough dispensers to do one side at the moment, so I'm only going to focus on the one side. We'll leave this one for another day. So once we come through here, the best way then, let's think about this, so that's one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we need to remove this one and this one. In fact, let's just strip all of this out. See what we're doing properly then. Okay, so that signal's going to come in this way. The best way to do this would be half slabs, perhaps? I haven't got a crafting table over here, let's just grab some half slabs quickly. So if we have a repeater, something like this, maybe. Dig some more out. In fact, is that high enough? No, no, we'll go one more. So the dispensers are going to sit on these blocks. That's going to power that already, is it? Let's see. Nope, doesn't seem to. So we can take this signal now across the back, and that should power them. Can't really tell. Let's have a look. Oh my word. Oh my word. Excellent. Oops. So now we can carry this signal all the way along the back, clear out some more space again. Four blocks along here, and probably a repeater. Here. Yep. So it's going to use a lot of water buckets, but I want something fancy, something a bit different from the norm. Now, the only problem is, can I? Might have to take this down another block so that I've got room to put the floor in. Alright, so all the circuitry's in place now. It's all tucked away under here. If I quickly hop up here, I can show you. Sneak through here, that's it. Better put some torches up, actually. Too high space. So it all leads up, and then there's a repeater just to stagger everything, keep the signal nice and strong. So the last thing to do is plonk the water buckets in. And looking at this, I don't like that you can see the dispensers. Might have to move those. I think they could probably go there instead, maybe. Or even there, and they'd be completely hidden behind this. Could perhaps even then go another chest higher as well. I think I might do that, in fact. But just to give you some idea, This would be walking out. And then when you come in, everything's exposed, ready to access. So I've got the rest of the chests in place now. It's so nice to have somewhere to keep storing all these things. So I don't have to keep using all these chests that are scattered around all over the place. But I'm out of bows now to make dispensers with, unfortunately. I need to go and farm some string. I know there's that spider spawner over at the mesa, which is... yeah, it's going to be that way. So I might go over there and collect some string up, get the rest of the bows that I need together. Because I need, what, 2, 4, 6, 8. 10 more dispensers altogether to finish this. And I think I will make them 3 chests high as well. I'll definitely tuck them out of the way a bit more. But this just gives you an idea of what it's going to look like. So I think I might rearrange it now, actually. Save putting it off for another day. Back shortly. Yeah, definitely like that a lot better. So when you walk in now, it's less obvious where the dispensers are. You have to get right up close to see them. And this gives me opportunities for maybe putting some glowstone in there as well, or perhaps even in the floor. Not too sure yet. Or even just behind the chests. Actually, because one thing I don't like at the moment is I've got all this torch spam going on. They don't look too bad on a wall like this, for example, but when they're just on the floor, this is terrible. I have to eradicate this across the base eventually. It's either going to be torches on a wall, maybe do the item frame trick, I don't know, try and make them look nicer. Something other than this, anyway. I think I want to remove another strip here. And then arch this ceiling as well. Oops. There we go. Oh, this is so good. Somewhere to put all the stuff now. Oh, of course, I can't open that chest, so that's going to have to be stairs. That's no problem. Quick fix. That's better. Right, so what should we have in here? We'll have stone in this one, I think. And we'll have quite a bit of that, I imagine, so... and then the stone bricks... things like the stone brick stairs, these slabs can go in, and on the next one down maybe the woods. I don't know, I can organise these a little bit more later, but I've got something else in mind that I want to do today as well. I want to go to the Nether. I want to go and see what it looks like in there. That's why I've borrowed this armour from the skeletons. It's not great, but yeah, it's got a few protections on it, some projectile protection, some feather falling. It'll do for the first trip, should we say. But where to put the portal is the thing. I want it somewhere central, for definite. Preferably somewhere in this main room as you come in. Or maybe in here, in fact. Yeah, I could use this room, I suppose. Or... a big portal in here. I'll have a think while I gather up some obsidian, anyway. Oh boy. The first trip in, I think, is always the worst. You never know what's going to happen. You could get shot by a ghast the second you walk in. You could get assaulted by wither skeletons, magma cubes. Oh, nothing for it. Taking the very bare minimum of supplies in. I am taking my silk touch pick and my good bow. Figure I'm going to need all the help I can get. Well, let's stop talking about it. Oh, where's it going to put me? Oh, well, that's... That's pretty good. You just see the fortress in the distance there. I got a ghast as well. Oh, two. Oh, nearly. Come on. How has that not killed him yet? Oh, come on. You know what? He's walking away. Leave him alone. Nope, he's coming back. Oh. Didn't drop a tear. That's a shame. There's a wither skeleton. Is it? Yep. Oh. Did he drop a skull? Are we going to be that lucky? No, no skull. Plenty of nether quartz already around though. Let's start gathering some of that up straight away. So I don't want to be here too long. I'm not exactly well equipped for this. Hello. I'd like to get to that fortress. Let's have a look. What's the worst that could happen? Well, I could fall in lava and die. I could get withered and die. Oh, so many pigmen. Oh, look at that. Check there's nothing around that's going to eat me. Nope, are we all good? Not all that much of it, but... I've never seen it buried like that before. That's new. Bit dark. Don't mind me. Dear. Ouch. Oh, come on. Can we get up to that fortress or not? Looks fairly close. Oh wow. Steady as she goes. If I can get across that lava, I can get in. I heard you. Oh boy. Now what? Oh wow. Complete fluke. Let's get out of that way. That one. Ooh. Still no tears. Oh, one. Are you going to fall down on me? Oh, I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous. I want to get in that fortress. There's just so many skeletons sitting on top of it. Just gonna have to go for it, aren't I? Let's pillar up. I hope there's not one at the top to greet us. Alright, let's torch as we go along. Oops. And keep them at range. Get rid of you. We're being shot at again. Yep. Heard that, where are you? Oh, there you are. Seems to be that's the inside of the fortress there. Wow, there's lava pouring into this fortress and everything. Continues that way. Whew. One blaze rod. Oh, okay. See you later. I need to get across here. Whoops. Oh, please don't, please don't. Come on, heal through it, heal through it. Whew. You know what? I think the fortress is for another day. I think we're going to call it there. I'm going to get home. What? Another portal's still broken? Alright, so if you saw in that last clip, I thought that maybe nether portals were broken. I don't think they are still. so... To try and explain this as best as I can, this portal is centered at X-249Z70, if I jump up on here. And then when I go into the nether, I appear at X0Z5, which is a long way out from what it should be. It should be somewhere nearer, I'll get this right, X-31Z9. So minus 31, somewhere over that way, somewhere. So I'm guessing that because it couldn't spawn, this is obviously a solid chunk of netherrack, so the portal couldn't spawn in there, so it's moved it all the way out here, which means when we go back through, we should appear somewhere around X minus 8, Z32. I'll just give it a moment. X18, Z29. So I don't think they're broken, I just think I need to resync the one in the nether. I'm going to tear this one down and then head back over to the base, go back through that portal and move the one that's in the nether to where it's supposed to be. And fingers crossed that will all work out. But as Jeremy Clarkson would say, on that bombshell, I'm going to end the episode here. Thank you very much for watching. If you've enjoyed the video, please head down the bottom and click the like button. And if you're really enjoying the videos, don't forget you can always hit subscribe as well. I've been AngryTerrapin and I'm confused. What went wrong? What went wrong?